At the 10th place on the list goes to Karyu. He was the leader of the Dark Thunder group. By combining the earth and fire natures, Karyu was capable of using the lava release Keke Genkai. With it, he was able to create a black vulcanized rubber-like material that took the form of spherical projectiles and defensive walls. In the fight against Sasuke, we just see him using lava-style rubber ball and lava-style rubber wall. He was easily defeated by Sasuke, but because of his better abilities in lava release, he takes 10th place. Kyosuke was the former member of Akatsuki. He was the shinobi from Amegakure. Kyosuke was able to combine earth and fire nature chakra to use lava release ninjutsu, which took the form of quicklime via lava release. Quicklime Kungliling technique. With this, he can make cement-like substance that can turn anyone into cement. As we see his fight against Obito, we didn't have any information regarding his skills in other nature transformation or any technique, but because he was Akatsuki member and has good speed, he easily earns this placement. Now, Boro was the inner member of Kara organization and one of the strongest as well. His skills with earth, water, fire, and yin release were immense, but Boro also has lava release, Keke Genkai, which lend him a hand in battle. In anime, we get to see him using his lava in the form of potent acid. He can use lava style, planet branding blast as explosion, and projectile. Against New Team 7, we see him melting shuriken with his lava style and using it from underground to melt anything it touches. Since we get to see him using just one lava release jutsu, that's why he is that low on the list, since this list is based on skills and feats with lava release, not power level. Todai was one of the most important shinobi in the 4th Great Shinobi War and highly skilled shinobi of Hidden Cloud Village. He just has fire and earth release, with both of them combined, he can use lava release. He uses his lava release as vulcanized rubber-like substance. With this, he can use a rubber ball, and with this, he can cover anyone and himself to block multiple of devastating techniques. He can also use this technique to attack anyone with his lava release. With his lava release, rubber defense. He was strong enough to dodge 2 meteors from the sky at the same time with any injury. He can also use rubber rope to save an ally from strong attacks, as we see him saving Naruto from the 3rd Rikage. He can also use rubber wall, which was strong enough to stop 3rd Rikage's 4-finger attack for a while. He just uses his lava release for defense, that's why he gets this place.
Now, we never get to see Onoki using lava release in anime, but in novels, he used lava release without any effort after combining 2 chakra natures. With that, he can use lava release. In Shikamaru Shinden, Onoki has mastery in the Keke Genkai, so it is clear that his skill with lava release might be better than characters before him, since he is one of the best earth style and dust release users in the series. Dust release requires fire, earth, and wind release, and lava release requires first 2, one which are fire and earth release. So he easily deserves this placement in skill of the Keke Genkai, because high proficiency in battle and jujutsus.
Kurotsuchi is a highly capable kunoichi. With skills of her, she was chosen to guard Onoki from troubles. She is one of the best lava release users, as we see her restraining Kinshiki with it, the planet level Otsutsuki. She can use her lava release in 2 forms. First use of it was that she uses her lava release as quicklime to attack the opponent, which is called lava release, quicklime Kungliling technique. Her quicklime jutsu is like fast-acting cement, and after combining it with her water style, she can increase the range of it and cause it to harden like cement, as we see her fight with Kabuto and other characters. And second use is to expel ash to restrain with her lava release, ash stone seal technique, as she does with Kinshiki Otsutsuki. Restraining an Otsutsuki with just lava release is impressive, and that gives her 5th place on our list. Mei is one of the best lava release users in the history of Naruto anime, and her feats with are immense. She uses her lava release in pure boil and has a strong acidic mud flow. She uses 2 forms of her lava release, melting apparition technique, first one which is in pure lava form that can melt anything and get hardened after a few seconds, as she uses in her fight against Sasuke to block his way and melt his Susanoo partially. Second form is in yellow acid form. The use of it is same as before, but she can use this in large amount, and it didn't get hard immediately. She uses it in her fight against Zetsu to melt his wood-style roots and Madara skeleton Susanoo. She can also use lava style, lava monster crest. She uses it in Ninja Storm game as an offensive jutsu. First, she uses torrents of water and finish it with lava release, spitting a small high force shot of lava from her mouth at a high speed, which gives high damage to opponent. Her use of this Kekkeigenkai and mastery over it gives her this placement on list. If we are talking about lava release and didn't include Roshi on the list, then the list is still incomplete. Roshi was the Jinchūriki of Four Tails, which has lava release Kekkeigenkai, so he didn't have any problem using it. With the Kekkeigenkai lava style scorching rocks jutsu, with this he could spew multiple molten rocks from his mouth, firing them in different directions to make it difficult for an enemy to evade. He is able to create an armor of lava, his own version of Tailed Beast Chakra mode that will burn anyone or anything that comes into contact with him. This cloak also increases the damage of his taijutsu attacks to the point that I could burn Naruto in his Nine Tails Chakra mode despite not making physical contact with him. He also gives tough fight to Kisame Hoshigaki with his lava release techniques. Because of his mid feats, he gets this place, but the next one is even better than him using lava release. Second place goes to Son Goku, the four-tailed beast. I don't think anyone didn't know about him. All abilities that Roshi and Naruto have been completely belong to Son Goku. He can use lava release as much high capacity than Roshi, as we see him using lava style. Flower Fruit Mountain, he creates a volcano which then explodes violently, sending molten rock flying up in all directions, the effects of which resemble a giant flower. The lava produced is said to be able to melt anything in its path. He uses this technique against Naruto and Killer Bee. Son Goku also spews green flames at the opponent, which can burn anything and destroy which get contact with it. He can also use all techniques that Roshi can use. He gets second place on list. And of course, the strongest lava release user is Naruto Uzumaki. After gaining 6 Spats Chakra from Hagoromo, Naruto gained his access to Kekkeigenkai of all Bijus. In this, he also gets his hands on lava release. He himself can use Son Goku's lava style, and after combining it with his Rasen Shuriken, he easily cut the God Tree and Jubidara in half in single attack. We also see him using this against Kaguya Otsutsuki and cut her arm with his Sage Art. Super-tailed Beast Rasen Shuriken with also includes Lava Release Rasen Shuriken, feats that any other lava style user might never accomplish in any fight. He can use all lava style abilities which Son Goku and Roshi can use, so he easily deserves the number one spot. That's the end of the video. Like and subscribe for more, and watch these other videos too. See you soon, goodbye for now.